You know what the trouble with us, Vera? We think we're the inmates. We forget that we can walk out of this place whenever we like.
Oh, I'm sorry, Jim. I've had this headache all day.
Well, it's no wonder this place is probably getting to you. You ought to get out more. You know, I had to force myself to go out last night. You got no idea what an effort it was.
Don't I?
But I had the time of my life. I mean, it's done me a hell of a lot more good than the satisfaction of a job well done.
Well, it's easier for men.
Well, not for me, it's not. I mean, you ought to develop some other interests. This place, it's so depressing. You've got to have a safety valve. Get out of your rut while you can.
Well, there's not much chance of that with the rosters you've drawn up for next week.
Oh, yeah, that reminds me. Got to make a change to that roster.
I had a go and I can't do it.
You didn't hurt the kid, did you? You know I advised against that.
No, I couldn't even get near her. She was fast asleep, bloody babe in the woods.
What's a hit, man? You've got a long way to go, Kathleen.
Yeah, well, some of us have got it and some of us haven't.
I hear McNally's got heaps.
What am I going to do? I
told you before, get yourself hurt, make yourself an alibi.
Well, I wouldn't do it right. I'd probably miss or kill myself.
Maybe I should do you a favour and knock you around a bit. But then they'd just land me back in the pound. I think I've had enough of that.
Can't you think of something else?
I'm thinking. Mind you, you've been a bit naughty, you know, playing in the gutter with pushers. Don't deserve to get off scot-free.
Yeah, well, I didn't know they were going to ask me to kill somebody.
Anyway, give us a way I can help you. Grab the sheet off the press for me, will you?
Oh, sure.
Gorby, hope Kat's gonna be all right. You could have done a lot of damage to her poor hands.
This is a panic merchant, Lizzie. Let's put her out of action for a while.
Get back to work.
Oh, we was just having a few minutes silence for poor old Kat.
Well, save your sympathy for Smith. She's the one who'll be needing it once she's seen the governor.
You can't charge her over an accident.
Nothing Smith does is ever an accident.
They do happen, you know.
Not with you. Leach was just another victim on your list, wasn't she?
Kath didn't know what she was doing.
That's right. She should have watched where she was putting her hands.
Yeah, she's been a bit vague lately, you know.
Well, we'll let the governor decide that. Come on, Smith.
It's a frame-up! It wasn't an accident, was it?
No. No, Kath was set up by B to put her hands in that press.
Yeah, I seen it too. But why? She and Kath were always real good mates.
Geez, you've got to be a bird brain not to work that one out. Kath crossed B, that's for sure.
How?
Well, how should I know? But she got what's coming to her, and so will that Morris bitch. She's mixed up in it too.
Oh, pull your
no,
head
no,
in,
no, Doreen might have a point.
See, I told you.
Do you know something we don't know?
Well, maybe. But it's going to be a long time before we find out for sure. Because if Vera has her way, B'll be locked up for some time yet.
Yes, Doctor, I see. Would you let me know as soon as Leach is well enough to speak to me? Thank you.
How is she?
Not very well. She's in a great deal of pain, and both her hands are severely blistered.
Poor kid.
Your concern does you credit. Perhaps you'd tell me what happened.
Oh, Kath was giving me a hand with the sheets. She turned around to take a couple off the press that weren't ready. I didn't notice, and I brought the press down on her hands accidentally.
Rubbish.
Were you present, Miss Bennet?
No, but it doesn't take much imagination to work out what happened. Leach must have crossed Smith in some way, and so she had to be punished.
I suppose you would deny that.
Listen, Mrs. Davidson, I say it was an accident. Miss Bennet thinks it wasn't. But why would I want to hurt Kath?
You don't need a reason. Just another one of your little vendettas.
Prove it.
That's enough, Smith.
Ask Kath. She'll tell you.
After what you've done, do you think she'll speak?
With your record, Smith, I find it hard to believe that it was an accident. However, until we can question Leach, there is no proof to the contrary.
It was an accident.
So you say. But to avoid any more accidents, you will no longer be permitted to work the press, since you seem unable to work it responsibly.
Oh!
You are being let off lightly. Miss Bennet, would you take her back to the laundry and make sure she does not use the press?
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
What's that crap?
It's not crap. Listen.
Jeez. You You've got nice soft hands. It'd be a shame if anything happened to them.
What are you talking about?
Remember Kathleen? She's in hospital.
Why? What happened?
Got her hands caught in the press accidentally on purpose.
What are you on about?
Bea had to teach her a lesson.
Why?
Well, Kath done something to upset Bea. You should have heard her scream. Her hands came up all blistered from the steam. Must have been real painful.
You're hurting me.
Just a flea bite to what Bea'll do to you. I wouldn't be in your shoes for nothing.
You go back early?
Yes. For once, the police got a guard to the hospital quickly so I could get back.
How's Leach?
Oh, not too bad. She's been sedated, but the doctors don't think there'll be any permanent damage to her hands.
Good.
This week's rosters. Tell me the worst.
Well, look, will you be right for a double shift today and then another one later in the week?
Maybe I should bring in my bed and take up permanent residence.
Oh, come on. It's not that bad. When Officer Powell gets back from sick leave, we'll be able to take it quite a lot easier.
You seem to be taking it easier already.
How's that?
Vera, myself and Jenny are all on two double shift and you haven't even got one.
So?
Well, yesterday you made a remark. I thought it was a joke about you changing your shift. Surely you're not asking us to work harder in order to accommodate your social life.
As deputy governor, it's my duty to compile the rosters. Now, they're done. I don't want to debate them with you now.
Well, all I can say is the deputy governor is in a very privileged position.
Yeah. Well, I didn't expect to see you after her little trick with Kath.
No, what could Dave do? Even Vera couldn't prove it wasn't an accident.
Uh-huh. And was it?
No.
So why then?
Did you know Kath was a plant?
What are you talking about?
She was put in here to keep an eye on Tracy. But when things got too hot to handle, she got the message that Tracy had to go.
Oh, come on, Kath's no killer.
No, but... she got a little prezi yesterday. A knife.
Was she going to use it?
No, she was scared of her wits, poor kid. She didn't want to kill Tracy, but she knew if she didn't, the big boys would be out after her. So I did her a favor. I put her out of action for a while.
Oh, wow. Well, at least the two of them are safe now.
Kath might be. Tracy isn't. She's going to testify against her friends in court, and they don't like that. They'll do anything they can to wipe her out.
You know, this is unbelievable. I mean, all the girl does is do a favor for a friend. She takes a suitcase. Suddenly all hell breaks loose. It's like the mafia or something.
Yeah, well, drugs is the most filthy, dangerous game you can poke your nose into.
So what's going to happen to her?
Oh, nothing if I can help it. But they'll probably plant someone else in here, so we'll have to keep a pretty sharp eye on her.
Well, I'm sure we can offer her protection as long as we work together.
Yeah, but we'll have to be careful.
Why? We're not in any danger.
You want to bet? As long as we're in between Tracy and whoever it is that's out to get her, we're in the firing line.
Well, it won't stop me.
Well, it won't stop me either. I'm just saying we're going to have to be careful of ourselves as well as Tracy. This is a very big, very dirty business.
Now, Tracy Morris. As you are all aware, she has been returned here in protective custody.
But surely that's a police matter. Why aren't they looking after her?
Neither the police nor Morris herself were aware of her danger until she went out on bail. She now needs constant surveillance. It is our job to see that she gets adequate protection.
Surely we're doing all we can.
The police have asked for extra security. Any visitor she has must be approved by me.
Well, her father will be visiting her. Does that include him?
All visitors, Mrs. Jackson. If I am not here, they are to be reported to Mr. Fletcher for his approval. Everyone will need to be searched.
Well, that's all very well, Mrs. Davidson. But the staff is under enough pressure as it is without wrapping Morris in cotton wool.
The request came from Inspector Grace.
The simplest solution is to put the girl in isolation and allow her no visitors.
I am not discussing these measures, Miss Bennett. I am telling you what is to happen. In addition to these precautions, I would also like you to keep a close eye on any relationship she may form with the other inmates, especially newcomers. Now, Doreen Burns. It seems she is not coping very well since the loss of her baby. Are there any comments?
Well, I'm not surprised with all that's happened. It's one disaster after another.
The worst thing is she seems to be alienating herself from the other women.
Oh, she's wallowing in self-pity. What she really
needs... Harshness will not solve Byrne's problem.
Well, she's due for parole soon, isn't she?
That is correct. But she's not ready for it in her present state.